Growing up, I used to have those head across tackles where I used to get my bell rung. I was like, asking coach, what happened?
This is Scott Lawyer. He started playing football when he was 10 years old and continued into college. When he says getting your bell rung, he means getting a concussion. It's a term you hear all of the time in football because, well, concussions are kind of common. At its worst, the latest studies show repeated brain trauma causes a sometimes fatal condition called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE. The research has some prominent neurologists saying that there's no safe way to play tackle football, and it's forced the NFL to look for ways to make the most popular sport in the U.S. safer.
You don't have to go too far to know somebody that is concerned about their kid playing football because of this safety issue and this concussion and CTE issue.
Karen Bryant is the CEO of Atavis, where Scott works. The company wants to change how football players tackle. Atavis is part of a boutique industry that's emerged in recent years of companies aiming to improve the sport.
We believe that the long-term impact, the biggest impact, is to focus on changing behavior. Changing behavior of coaches, changing the approach of coaches, and ultimately changing the way players tackle and the way they're taught to tackle.
Here's how it works. Notice how Scott pushes off his right foot and strikes with his right shoulder. He uses the same foot and shoulder to maintain momentum while keeping his head out of play. This is what it looks like in a game, in a commercial the NFL made, calling the tackle the future of football.
There's no head involved in these tackles at all. We think it's safer.
For comparison, this is what a normal, non-Atavis tackle looks like.
You grow up with the style of head across. It's hard to get that out of your mind, but that muscle memory from Atavis and the strategic and the systematic approach we take really helps players have that muscle memory and really feel it come second nature to them.
A handful of major colleges and one pro team have adopted this brand of tackling, but Atavis has only been around since 2013, and they're still gathering data to test whether their tackle is safer. Even if it is, sometimes players will still get hit in the head. That's something other startups, like this company, Vysys, are trying to address. Vysys got a grant from the NFL to try to build a better helmet.
Our focus is just building a helmet that reduces impact forces. Traditional helmets have a hard plastic shell and some sort of padding on the inside. Our helmet actually deforms or yields upon impact like a car bumper would, and in doing so, it slows impact forces before they can reach the head. Depending on the location, we can reduce those impact forces by 40% or so.
More than 20 college teams and at least a dozen NFL teams will have players wearing the 01 in 2018. But like Atavis, their work is so new that they don't have the data to show whether their helmets prevent CTE.
We don't make any claims about our helmet's ability to reduce concussion risk or CTE risk. What we do is we say, here's the data. Our helmet reduces impact forces more effectively than other helmets.
These startups are a step in the right direction, but most experts say improving tackles and helmets alone won't eliminate concussions from the game.
When you hit here, your neck starts moving. And it whips the brain around, and that's what I believe, and I think a lot of other people believe, causes concussions. So if you want to eliminate concussions, you need to do something about the neck movement.
Dr. Jam Gahar is the director of Stanford University's Concussion and Brain Performance Center and a professor of neurosurgery. He says a lot of research suggests that the sudden rotation of the skull is what most damages the brain, even if the head is protected. Gajar says solving this would make a lot of sports safer, not just football.
It'll be a very small device linking the back of the neck, and it'll prevent this certain kind of motion that's producing concussions. And that'll be the cure. And then you can do all these sports and even martial arts and boxing. You'll have a dramatic decrease in concussions, better brain health, better performance. It's all that, but we have to understand what the problem is first.
He believes we're working towards a future where playing America's favorite sport won't mean putting your brain at risk. But we've still got a long way to go.
Something has to change. I think you'd be hard-pressed to find anybody, layperson, hardcore football fan, that wouldn't acknowledge that something has to give. So whether the word drastic is appropriate or not, don't know. Can't comment on sort of how drastic that change might be, but something has to change.